Hey everyone, I got a cool video for you today. In this video, I'm gonna go over the AI app Grok, which is from X. It's a really cool AI app, text to image. It can also do videos too. But in this video, I wanted to test it out and see how well it does with a style that I just found on Etsy. So I'm gonna go to Etsy first, show you this style that I found for Christmas. It can be used for any niche, by the way. And I'm gonna show you that it sells with ProfitTree. And then take that style, write some prompts, and take that style over to Grok and see how it does. So lots to see in this video. Hopefully it all works out in the end. Let's get to Etsy first, and then I'll show you this style that I found. All right, so here I am on Etsy. You can kind of see the styles already because I've been looking for it. Here's this like vintage cartoon style. You can see it here and here. And I think this one kind of counts too, kind of this vintage 60s illustration. So the way I found it is I went to Etsy first and I just typed in funny Christmas t-shirt. There you go. And let's let it load. By the way, I'm using this Etsy Radar. Etsy Radar is part of ProfitTree. You get that with the $67 lifetime plan that I'm using currently. So that's why it works. No monthly fees, just a one-time $67, and you can get this as well as some other things on there, but this shows right into Etsy, so you can see how many sales this one's getting. 722 sales already this month, 19k. This one's 15 sales, over 400k. This is Scrooge, but you can kind of see that's that style anyway. So this is kind of that style, but it's not as colorful. I'm looking for like the colorful one. See that? So I'm going to see if we can take this style and put it into Grok and see if Grok can do this. Like, you could draw this yourself. It may take a long, long time, but can Grok take this idea and do it? Now, you're going to have to write some prompts, and I wrote some long ones, so I'll put that up here. But again, I wanted to show that, like, it's really nice that this Etsy Radar is working, because you can see like that didn't sell, that didn't sell, but you can see some other things that do sell. There's another one, but that's an elf. So, but it's that style too, right? This one's kind of cool. So it's really nice to see that. Oh, by the way, ProfitTree also does this. So if you come in here, it's also in here. So you can see even more details, more data of that. So again, the radar here. You can get ProfitTree. I'll put a link in the description here if you want to see this kind of information and see what's selling on Etsy, what's a bestseller. I mean, you can always see bestseller, but you can see actually how much it sold too. So let's get a Grok right now, and I'll write the prompts on the side. I'll show you what those are when we get there. All right, so here we are on Grok, grok.com. Now, it's free for a limited amount of graphics, so it's not like free forever, you can use it. So there is a limit, and hopefully I don't hit the limit because I've been using it. Hopefully we don't hit the limit in this video. I know there's a limit. I don't even know where I am on the limit, so crossing fingers that this is all gonna work. So there's chat, voice, image, imagine, that's the one we're gonna use. You can also hit create image here. I'm gonna click here and just show you kind of the things that Grok can do. Look at all of this stuff. So it does photorealistic stuff, it does cartoon, it does videos. So any one of the things that we're gonna create, you can also make videos just like that in here with Grok. So I'll show you that as well. So first things first, we're gonna have to type in a prompt here. Here's the prompt that I'm using. I'll show you right there. I wrote this out and had ChatGPT help me write this out as well. But I'm going to copy and paste that into here. So let me do that first. Copy and then paste right here. So you can see you can put all of that there. I'm going to move myself over here so you can see a few other things. So you can add image here if you want to by clicking on this. You can upload a file, draw a sketch if you want, and use any of these. And this right here is going to tell you what size we want. So I don't want the tall rectangle. I actually want a square because I need to have space for the words, right? So I'm going to do the square right here. You could also do this one, 3x2. You could also just do a video from the prompt that I'm putting in here, or an image. We're going to just make sure that it's image. And then I'm going to hit go. Now, one of the nice things about this is that it does a bunch of them, and you can keep scrolling through them to see which one you like the best. So like some of these are pretty cool. Let's see. So maybe that one. Let's do this one for now. I'm going to click on this, and you can see I can just make this a video, which would be really cool. But I could also download this, or I could share the link to this. I'm going to download this just so we have it. And then it opens it up here, and then just drag it here. Now, it's too small to be used for print on demand, but I can upscale it, and that's what I'll do. So I'm going to click out of it. I want to show you how easy it is to make a video though. So you can say what you want the video to be, and I'm going to hit make video, right? And oh, there we go. Now you can see it's going. Hopefully this doesn't use all my credits, but I think I can make 3 videos a day or something like that. And I only made 1 today. So let's see, it takes a little while. But it's pretty cool, and this is one of the ways you can use your artwork. You could drag in your artwork in here, your t-shirts that you did, and make a video for it and use that as a video for your ad. So let's see. Oh my goodness, that's so funny. You can see it kind of does random video, and you can type in what you want your video to be. So hopefully we can make a video for the next one. But the other thing I like is that, look at this. If you don't like these, you can scroll down, and it's in real time, it's creating more and more design. So maybe you want it to look like this. Maybe you want the boy sleeping. Now, if you want him sleeping instead of awake, you can do this. Let's see where I put it. So instead of up in bed, I could put of a sleeping child. Wide eye clutching the blanket. No, we don't want him clutching the blanket. We just want him sleeping. And then hit this again. And look, it's going to take the same thing, but it's gonna do it a little bit different. So maybe that's where you want it to be. He's sleeping like that. So really cool, it has the same style, and you can scroll until you find one that you like or change it. Like if you don't want this, you can change it. I think this one's pretty funny too. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna save this one too and hit download. Okay, that one just looks evil, which could be a funny one. Okay. Next thing we're gonna do is, let's do another one. I wrote another one for where the kids were doing the Christmas tree. So I'm gonna go back. Now I can still type another one here. So I have another prompt that I wrote. So this is the prompt right here for the children decorating the tree. Hopefully this works the same way. I really like this art style. This is really cool, like a comic book one. So I'm gonna copy and paste this one and then hit copy and command V into it, and let's go. Now it takes a little while, but it's pretty fast for all 8 that it's doing right at the beginning. And then, wow, this is really cool. I like this one already. I'm gonna click on this one and hit download. Look at that artwork. It even has like the halftones on it, which is really cool. And we can go back. And let's scroll and see some other one. This one's really cool too. Oh my goodness. So I'm just saving the ones that I like, dragging it off onto my board. But look at some of the other ones. They have other styles here. Like if you like this one, we have these other options, but I'm gonna go back. I like the style that it's doing here. That's really cool. That's really cool. So there's some really, really neat ones here. I like this one too. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. So very impressed with Grok. I'm impressed, like Philip, just amazing artwork on here. Go ahead and play around with it. I like doing it. And let's see, this one is a video too. So I'm gonna take this one. I'm gonna say, you can give it, I'm gonna say, have them decorating the tree. Have them decorating the tree. I don't think it remembered what I typed last time. So let's do this. Video options, make it fun. Okay. Oh, good. I didn't have to click that. It already knew. So this one's gonna be fun, them decorating the tree. I think this one's really cool layout too, because I like how it kind of fills that space with the snowflakes and everything. And this is just a fun one. I made one earlier with Santa on a surfboard, and hopefully I can find that. And look at that. It changed it. Oh, that is a fun one. I don't know why he put a star in there when there's a star already there, but look at that. That's so fun. And Grok just does it. So pretty cool. And then you can switch between picture and video, and picture and video. And this one is, you can save it or unsave it, thumbs up it, upscale the video if you want, edit the image if you want, and so on. I wonder what edit image is. Oh, so I can type in here what to change. So give the boy, let's see what it does. Give the boy a blue shirt. Let's just see what happens. Okay, so, oh wow, it did it. I gave both of them a blue shirt. So there you go. I like red better, but I just wanted to see if it was gonna change it totally. And it didn't, it pretty much stayed the same as that one. He has a star here, another star. So, I think he should be holding an ornament, not a star, because anyway, I didn't catch that the last time. So let me know what you think of Grok. The thing I really like about Grok is this, like the endless thing. I think this is gonna be the future of AI because it just gives you so many options here. Instead of having to type, make this different, you can just see like, get something really close to what you wanted to anyway. So yeah, really cool that it does this. Now it does eat up your credit, so don't do a lot of this and keep scrolling, especially if you want to do more, because I think it's, I don't know how many credits or what, it doesn't say, but I know this is taking up some of your space that you get for free. So be careful of that. If you don't see something you like within the first, I don't know, four rows, then maybe make the change in here first in your prompt. But really, really cool. I love the artwork. And two of these. Think of other things you can do in this style. Now you can use those prompts that I made there and then make the changes of it. But I think what's important was that vintage 1960s comic book style is what I'm seeing in here, and it's really, really cool. All right, just one last thing. I wanted to show you how easy it is to make this a t-shirt design. So now that I have this, I put it into a rectangle. You can see right here, I made a rectangle, a round rectangle with the corners at 7%. Made a red border around it. I'm just using this font and this font here. This font's called Hello Handmade Sans, and this one is Thirsty Soft. I don't believe they're free. I think I bought them, but you can use whatever font you want. But look at that. I'm just putting text and text above and below, kind of that sandwich idea with this, and it just works perfectly. It works on black. I think it would work on red too. So let me change like this on red. Now I could change the border on here. So if I made the border white too, check that out. Pretty cool. It looks kind of like a book, like an old-timey book. But yeah, these work out great. I'm gonna try it out with this one and this one next time. I didn't want to use this one here only because the boy was awake here. So I was looking for one where it's more creepy, where he's looking at him sleep, let this person sleeping. So there you go. You don't have to use this one. I'm just showing you that you can use Grok to make vintage 60s artwork and then get creative and put the words on here and something. So you don't have to do Christmas. I know other holidays are coming up. Try and find a funny one for New Year's or for Valentine's or for anything, right? Just come up with some funny creepy things. I think it works because this is kind of creepy, but it doesn't have to be creepy. It can be funny in a different way. So have fun with this. This is free, by the way. This is Affinity by Canva. I do a lot of tutorials on my channel with Affinity by Canva. And just plop it in and put it in the frame and add some words. It's really, really simple. So there you go. That's how you use some of these apps. Profit free to do the research on Etsy. I'll put a link in the description. I'll also put a link to Grok, but you can really find that. Grok.com is pretty easy. Use a good prompt like this. You can use the prompts that I put in this video. And you can use Affinity by Canva to put it all together with the words and the graphic and everything. So really simple, and it didn't take me that long to do that. So have fun with this, get creative. You don't have to copy these. I just wanted to show you that you can use it for that, but I would say go and make your own so that you be first to the market with something funny and original. So have fun with that. Thanks again for watching. If you want to see another Canva video, I'll put my latest Canva video right here so you can see how Canva works and putting everything together. I've been having a lot of fun with it. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.